In this video, I present an action plan that you can use when you want to improvise bass lines. You'll see that you do not need to know much theoretical knowledge to start improvising. First of all, we need a chord progression for our improvisation. Let's use this. 1 bar D major, 1 bar F sharp minor, 1 bar B minor, and 1 bar G major. If you have trouble finding the root notes, check out the video I made about finding all the notes on the bass guitar in 5 minutes. The first and most important step of this action plan is rhythm. This is the basis for your bass line. You can already improvise a lot with only rhythm. For example, the next thing you can use are octaves. Since this is the same note as the root note, you can always use it without clashing the melody or harmony. You can find the octave of any note on the bass guitar doing the following. You slide 2 squares to the right in the direction of the body and 2 strings upward. Now, let's combine the first 2 steps using octaves in a rhythm. The next step would be using fifths. From this point on, it slightly starts getting theoretical, because there are different fifths. When you use which one depends on the chords that are played. But the perfect fifth is located in major and minor chords. That's the majority of the chords. So probably, most of the times, the perfect fifth is usable. You can find the fifth of any note on the bass guitar doing the following. You slide 2 squares to the right in the direction of the body and 1 string upward. You can also octave the fifth down. Now, let's combine this step with rhythm. And combine it with using the octaves as well. Next up, you can use thirds. A basic explanation in short. Major has a major third, a 3, and minor has a minor third, a flat 3. You can find the thirds on different places from the root note. Actually, this is also true for octaves and fifths. I elaborate on this in the interval video. For now, we use only one way. Playing the major third contains sliding 1 square to the left, in the direction of the head, and 1 string upward. Playing the minor third contains sliding 2 squares to the left, and 1 string upward. Let's first combine this step with rhythm. And now use all the other previous steps as well. Another thing you can use is to play towards the next root note. So, when you play the first bar, D major, you already start thinking about the second bar, F sharp minor. You can play towards this note from above or below. Depending on the rhythm, you decide how many notes you want to play towards the next root note. Let's combine it all. The next step is to use pentatonic scales. We will use two scales. Major pentatonic, that can be used on every major chord. We already have the root note, third, fifth and octave, and with this scale we add the intervals second and sixth. The other pentatonic scale is minor pentatonic, that can be used on every minor chord. We already have the root note, third, fifth and octave, and with this scale we add the fourth and seventh. Why the pentatonic scale consists of these extra notes, I explain at SV method. Let's combine all the steps so far. You now have seen that you can improvise a lot without much theoretical knowledge. But theory can give you inspiration. These next steps, it's getting more theoretical. This seventh step contains playing church scales. Every chord in a chord progression has a scale that sounds natural. If you want to know more about this, you can check out SV method. In this chord progression, it's the following. These scales consist of a series of intervals. I elaborate on this in the church mode video. From the previous steps, you already know six intervals. So this next step provides you with two additional notes. You can add these new intervals in your improvisation. We've now used the scales belonging to the chords in the chord progression. You can also use the intervals that are not located in the scales. For example, when we look at the D major scale, these intervals are not located in the scale. This means that these notes are not natural to the chords in the context of the progression. It's good to be aware of that, and it can actually be pretty cool to use them. You may have already used some of them in step 5. So, this actually means you can play any note. You may ask, why use an action plan? That's because every note has its own function, and when you can play just any note, it doesn't mean that any note will sound right to you. When you know the function of the note, you can start using it creatively in your bass line.